فما ظنكم بالنجل عند جزائه أولئك أهل الله والصفوة الملا أولو البر والإحسان والصبر والتقى حلاهم بها جاء القرآن مفصلا عليك بها ما عشت فيها منافسا وبع نفسك الدنيا بأنفاسها العلا جزى الله بالخيرات عنا أئمة لنا نقل القرآن عذبا وسلسلا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة والتسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We continue by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessings our reflections on the lives of the Qurra, the reciters of the Quran who transmitted this great message to us over the generations. And we are still talking about Sayyiduna Mus'ab bin Umayr radiallahu ta'ala anhu Allah. And this great Sahabi who used to be called Al-Muqri, the teacher of the Quran in Al-Madina, and he was the first ambassador of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to another place. And we mentioned that there were many characteristics that made our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam choose Sayyiduna Mus'ab as the first ambassador of Islam, the first da'i, the first messenger of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we mentioned his sacrifice radiallahu anhu when he migrated to Abyssinia, Ethiopia in our days. And we read that he was walking barefooted radiallahu anhu, and he was bleeding until his friend Amir bin Rabi'ah, he gave him his shoes. Those great people, they sacrificed a lot. And Sayyidina Mus'ab, he migrated twice to Ethiopia or Abyssinia, and he got a lot of experience. And he got a lot of knowledge and experience how to deal with others, how to deal with people who are not from his own country. So he had this experience, radiallahu anhu. He had the courage, he had the knowledge of the Quran, he had the love for Allah and his messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These are the main qualities that made Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam choose Sayyidina Mus'ab bin Umayr to be the first ambassador. We, and again I remind you of this hadith narrated by Imam Abu Nu'aym and others, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at Sayyidina Mus'ab one day and saw him putting a belt from the skin of the sheep, and he said, look at this man that Allah illuminated his heart. Allahu Akbar, look at this testimony from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's saying, look at this man that Allah illuminated his heart. I know him in Mecca, his parents used to provide him with the best types of food and drink. And I know that once he got a garment or a piece of clothing for 100 dirhams. And now, this is how he looked. He looked as a very poor person, and this is what the love for Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam led him to. So he is showing us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that this man has an illuminated heart, and his love for Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam pushed him and made him sacrifice and leave all of those worldly pleasures of food and drink and clothing, because all of this is temporary and will end. So Sayyidina Mus'ab radiallahu anhu sacrificed, and we talked about his love for Allah and his messenger, and today we will finish inshallah talking about his blessed life with talking about his wisdom and his courage. His wisdom, which is the hikmah. And the hikmah is something that is unknown by so many Muslims. Even though hikmah is one of the three things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent our messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to teach. We read in the Quran in many ayats, like in Surah Al-Baqarah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, رَبَّنَا وَبْعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. In Surah Ali Imran we read, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعْثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. Look at this blessed ayah, dear brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling that He has done a big favor to the believers when He sent to them a messenger from among themselves. Allah has done a great favor to the believers when He sent to them a messenger from among themselves. What does this messenger do, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. That He narrates and recites His verses, He recites the Qur'an to them, and He teaches them the book, the Qur'an, and wisdom, al-hikmah. وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. And He purifies them. He purifies their hearts from the moral diseases, from the disbelief diseases, from all types of diseases. He purifies them with tazkiyah. So these are the three things our Messenger ﷺ was sent to teach. The reciting the book, and teaching the book, and teaching wisdom, and purification of the soul. So wisdom is, as the scholars mentioned, is to do the right thing in the right way at the right time. Is to do the right thing in the right way at the right time. Many times you see something wrong, but it's not good to change it right away. You see something wrong, but sometimes it's not wise to change it at all, because if you change it, something worse will be resulted. So wisdom is something very deep and very important that we really need to learn about. And our beloved sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in the hadith that one of the things that you should envy others in means you should wish to get and to have and to acquire is wisdom. Is a man who have wisdom and who's dealing with others through wisdom day and night. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us wisdom. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, وَمَنْ يُؤْتِ الْحِكْمَةَ in Surah Al-Baqarah, يُؤْتِ الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. That Allah gives wisdom to whom He wills. Oh Allah, grant us wisdom, Ya Arham Ar-Rahimeen. He grants wisdom to whom He wills. Then He said, وَمَنْ يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. And whoever is granted wisdom, he has been given a lot of good. Whoever is granted wisdom, he has been given a lot of good. خَيْر, a lot of good, a lot of خَيْر. And Sayyidina Mus'ab, by the way, he was given the title Mus'ab al-Khayr. Mus'ab, the one who has a lot of good, radiallahu anhu wa Allah. So one example about his wisdom, radiallahu anhu, when he was in Al-Madinah and he was calling others to Islam, calling the people of Al-Madinah to Islam, he was sitting with some of the leaders, and Usayd bin Hudayr, one of the heads of Al-Ansar, one of the leaders of that city, he came and he was very upset, and he came with his spear. And he was angry. He said, who is this person who wants to spread this thing, this new thing among us? He is a stranger and he's coming to our one city and he's making people change their religion. Who is he? So he got mad with him and he had his spear and he went. So when Sayyidina Mus'ab radiallahu anhu saw him, he did not shout at him, he did not tell him, I am free, I can do whatever. He said, if you like, you can sit and listen. And listen to what I have. If you like it, you can accept it. And if you don't like it, we will not harm you with anything you don't like. We will leave you. We will not bring you something that you don't like. With these simple words, this great Sahabi, this great ambassador, this great da'i, Sayyidina Mus'ab ibn Umayr radiallahu anhu, he made that man who came very angry and upset, he made him cool down, and he made him calm, and he sat, and he said, that's good, okay, let me listen. So he sat, and he listened, and with the recitation of the Qur'an, the beautiful recitation of Sayyidina Mus'ab bin Umayr radiallahu anhu that he learned from his messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the man started changing and his face started changing and he accepted Islam. That is hikmah, that is wisdom. How to deal with people in different situations, in different circumstances. You cannot deal with all people the same way. You cannot deal with all people in all places the same way. And this is why in da'wah we need, in this country, we need the Muslims of this country, the people who were raised in this country, we need them more than others who come from overseas, because they know the habits of the people in this country. They have experience with them. They know what they like, they know what they don't like. So they don't say words that will offend them. They will not bring or be in, put them in situations that they don't like. So the da'i is required to have this understanding and this wisdom and this knowledge about the people whom he are calling. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us wisdom. Sayyidina Mus'ab radiallahu anhu, and this is the second and the last characteristic I'm going to mention about him radiallahu anhu that qualified him to be the first ambassador and the first messenger of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was his courage. He was a courageous man. He was a brave man. He was a champion. He migrated twice to Abyssinia. Left his mother, left everything. Left all the luxury, left all the worldly things. He went to Al-Madinah and he spent long time calling to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Did not care about those leaders who might harm him, he did not care about anything of that. And he spread Islam in Al-Madinah. Dozens of Muslims accepted. Dozens of people of Al-Madinah accepted Islam through him radiallahu anhu. And he participated in all of the battles. And in the battle of Badr, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him the banner of Muslims. You know, the banner in those days, the banner of the army is very important. If it falls, means the army is collapsing. So when you give the banner of the army to someone, you must give it to the greatest one, to a courageous person who will keep raising the banner of the army, who held the banner of the migrants in the Battle of Badr, Sayyidina Mus'ab radiallahu anhu. Who gave it to him? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is an enough proof of his courage. And in the Battle of Uhud, he also got the banner radiallahu anhu. Sayyidina Mus'ab ibn Umayr, this young man who did not exceed 40 years of age, he held the banner with his right. And then Ibn Qami'ah, he came and he cut his right hand. He stabbed him or he cut his right hand, and Sayyidina Mus'ab radiallahu anhu right away he held the banner with his left. Then he cut his left and Sayyidina Mus'ab tried. Imagine, subhanAllah, this is not only Sayyidina Mus'ab. We know Sayyidina Ja'far al-Tayyar, right? Everyone knows Sayyidina Ja'far, who did the same thing. How these people, Allahu Akbar, how they, his hand is cut off and he holds the banner with his left. What iman they had, what love for Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam they had. What perseverance and patience, Allahu Akbar. So he held it, and then that man stabbed him until he fell radiallahu anhu, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed by him and made dua for him. And in some narrations he read the ayat, مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَا عَاهَدُوا اللَّهَ عَلَيْهِ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبَهُ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا. مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, from among the believers, there are men who were truthful people in their pledge with Allah. Look what a great testimony. From among the believers, there are men who were truthful. They are sincere in their pledge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They covered Sayyidina Mus'ab radiallahu anhu, who was one day the one who was living the most luxurious life in Mecca. When he passed away, Sayyidina Abdul Rahman bin Auf tells us as in Sahih al-Bukhari, we wanted to cover his body, we covered his head, then his feet are uncovered. We want to cover his feet, then his head is uncovered. They did not find enough piece of clothing to cover his blessed body radiallahu anhu. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, cover his head and put some leaves on his feet. Sayyidina Mus'ab ibn Umayr radiallahu anhu is a great man that we need to learn about his life more and more. He is a great man, a man of principles, a man of perseverance, a man of sacrifice, a man who can be a great, great role model for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward him for his sacrifice. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise his levels more and more. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower him with more blessings. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also mentioned in the hadith that he said, I testify that these are martyrs in the sight of Allah. And he said, visit, come to them and visit them. And anyone who gives salam to them, they will respond to him. Those great people are our role models. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower him with more blessings, along with those who were with him. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to follow their footsteps. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give relief to the brothers and sisters who are suffering everywhere. Wa salli Allahumma wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.